Yeah, you can show. You can show. Come on. Hare Krishna Ayansh. Hare Krishna Rudra Mukunda Vrinda Shri Leela. Happy to have you all, Soumya. So yes, you want to show your paper?
Yeah.
Okay, come on quick. Then you have to staple it to your...
Yeah.
Huh?
Hi.
Mataji, I have my friend here and she's going to recite with me. Her name is Pratika. Hi.
Pratika? Pratika? Pratita.
Yeah. Yes.
Pratita, give me a darshan, beta. How are you?
Hi, Pratita.
I'm good, and I'm going to watch Leela because that's what my mom told me to do.
And this is
the most boringest part.
Yes, you can also attend the class with Shri Leela, and I would love to hear you. Okay, beta? Welcome to the class. Yes, okay, Karima, show.
So this is my first shloka.
Yes, verse 1.
Yeah, and this is my second.
Yes, verse 2. Okay. Very good. Let's everybody start with the prayers. Number 16 quickly, we can just quickly speak our first two verses. Everybody together, unmute. Okay.
श्री भगवान उवाच अभयम् सत्त्व संशयम् ज्ञानयोगम्
Very good. Good job. So let's discuss third verse today with the meanings. Okay. So I'm just going to quickly speak. Nobody follow me. Tejah shamadhritihi shocham adroho nati manita bhavanti sampadam daivam abhijatasya bharata. Let's see what is the meaning of this. Very, very deep meanings. Okay. So let's start. What is it? Tejah. Now, Srila Prabhupada explains beautifully here. Tejah means what? Vigor. Vigor. So let's see what is exactly vigor. Of course, we all have to be very active in order to serve the Lord Krishna and his devotees. But here, Srila Prabhupada is explaining word Tejas here is meant for the Kshatriyas. Kshatriyas should always be very strong to be able to give protection to the weak. Suppose a king sees that somebody is hurting some animals,
so
or somebody is in his kingdom, some people are hurting others. So king must punish the one who is committing sinful acts, and he must protect the weaker society, weaker people. So that is called as tejah, means vigor. But they should not post themselves as non-violent. Kshatriya cannot say, oh, I'm a non-violent. I cannot hurt others. But that is Kshatriya's job, like king. King has to give protection. Similarly, in our society, the soldiers, the cops, they have to give protection to the common human beings. So they have to be in tejah. Okay. Next comes. Let's see what is next. Shama. Very beautiful word, shama, forgiveness. Right, Srila Prabhupada explains in continuity, but a person who is able to curb down his enemy may under certain conditions show forgiveness. He may excuse minor offenses, right? Same Kshatriya can forgive also others. And at the same time, like even a normal person should learn to excuse minor mistakes by others. Somebody says, sorry. Somebody says, oh, please forgive me. Let go. Forgive. Right? If forgiveness is also an important quality. We cannot just hold the grudges against people. We cannot hold wrong things in our mind for the people. Once they ask for forgiveness, we must forgive. Okay? So that is called as shama. Forgiveness is important. So a simple, if I give you a kiddie meaning, of course, forgiveness has a very huge and bigger meaning, but kiddie meaning, suppose in your classroom, in school, somebody stepped on your toes and they walked away. Okay. And immediately they realize and they turn back and say, sorry, but you say, oh, you hurt purposely. Oh, you did purposely. Oh, you were not supposed to do it. Oh, because you don't like me. That's why you hurt on my toes. And you keep grilling, you keep grudging, and you are not ready to forgive, even though your friend said, sorry. But you are not forgiving. So that's not a good characteristics, right? What we should do? We should forgive. Okay? Forgiveness. Then comes dhritihi. What is dhritihi? Dhritihi means, let me see what Srila Prabhupada says. Dhritihi means fortitude. Fortitude means having emotional and mental strength, even in the times of pain, misery. We should have courage. We should have emotional strength. So again, simple, it is almost related to forgiveness. Suppose somebody said very harsh words to us, right? And suppose, you know, some people are more emotional, some are less emotional, some doesn't even care. Okay, move on. Chalo, we got better things to do. We got a lot of things to do, but some people are very emotional. They hold on to it in their heart. And because of that, sometimes they respond in a very bad manner. Sometimes they develop envy. Sometimes they develop hatred. Sometimes they speak harsh words to others because they are not emotionally stable. Let's take an example that Soumya and Vrinda fight. Vrinda Rai. Okay, they both fight. Okay. Soumya speaks some bad words to Vrinda. And Vrinda, instead of letting it go, she's not emotionally very strong. And she says, oh, Soumya said this, Soumya said this. So she develops very bad feelings for Soumya. And maybe she tried to hurt Soumya. Or maybe she tried to develop envy for Soumya. Or she's not very emotionally strong. So she might do harm to herself. So that means she's not very emotionally strong. She's too much attached to her emotions, which is not okay. In our practical life, it's not okay. Emotionally being attached to Krishna, to the Lord, and his service is okay. If we have a service like Soumya, Soumya has a service of printing PDF for every chapter. She's very attached to her service. So emotionally being attached to your service or to the Lord is okay. But emotionally being attached to these temporary relationships and small things and behaving with others in a bad manner. Or sometimes you all have heard that our frustration sometimes come on other people, right? Not on our friend, but it ends up on other people.
I want
to tell an example that sometimes when we drive in the car, sometimes in the back, people scream that, why did you do this? And
yes.
They scream in the
yes.
back.
Yes. So Papaji, that should not happen. Yes. Tell me, Bita.
I did this activity with my brother. Yes.
Good job. I'm so proud of you. Yes, Bita. At the end, I'm going to ask everybody the activities. Okay. So that is called as Dhritihi. Then next comes, let's see what is in the shloka, Shaucham. What does Srila Prabhupada explains about Shaucham? Shaucham means cleanliness. Not only in the mind and the body, but in one dealings also, we should be clean. So every day we clean our body, we take shower. How do we clean our mind? Do we take a toothbrush and rub our mind every morning?
No.
Yes, I thought so. How do we clean our mind? Do we open our brain and clean it and close it back?
Oh, no.
How do we clean our mind? Yes. How do we clean our mind?
By chanting
Hare Krishna Mahamantra. It purifies our heart.
And
yes,
also you need to read Bhagavad Gita or Bhagavatam.
Of course, when we read Bhagavad Gita, when we read scriptures, when we hear Krishna Katha, when we think about Krishna, when we chant the holy name, it purifies our heart and our mind becomes clean. So it is important to clean our mind every single day. Do you all take shower every day?
Yes.
Or do you all take shower only once a week?
No.
So similarly, we have to chant every day to clean our mind, right? Otherwise, it will be too much dirt on our mind, right? So we must chant every day so that all dirt is gone. Rudra, beta, are you able to understand, Rudra? Yes, if you have a doubt, beta, ask me, okay? Okay, so what should we chant every day? We should chant our friend's name. Ayan Chayan
no.
Chayan Chayan.
Yeah, Ola Mantri.
Ayan Chayan, no. Should we chant candy?
No.
Candy.
No.
Very good. So that's how we clean our minds. But also our dealings should be clean. That means Srila Prabhupada says, like business people, when mercantile people, they should not deal with a black market. Means indirectly, we can say that money should not be made illegally or at the wrong places. Money should not be invested or dealt with. It's a little higher. So next part is, it's okay. Next part is adroho. Now, what is adroho? So let's see. What does Srila Prabhupada explains here? Adroho means freedom from envy, right? You all know, right? What is envy, right? Do you all know what is envy? Envy is, so jealousy and envy is almost same, right? Jealousy means, let's take an example that, Rudra. I am praising Rudra in every class. Every single class, I praise him, okay? And then Avyukta don't like it. Okay, and then Avyukta feel very bad that Mataji is not praising me and she's praising only Rudra every single day, every time. Then Avyukta feel bad. That is not really, really a jealousy because a teacher should deal with all children nicely. But it happens sometimes siblings, sometimes neighbors or let me try to see how do I explain you the envy properly. Okay, suppose my neighbor, okay, my neighbor has a car, okay. But he has a high-end car, but I have a little low-end car. Okay, he has a Mercedes Benz, and I have maybe a Nissan. Okay, and then I develop jealousy. Why does he has so much, and why do I have so little? I want to be rich like him. I want to have high-end car like him. So this is my jealousy. That means I'm kind of complaining Krishna that Krishna, you have not given me enough. That's not fair to me. But envy is higher. Envy is something when out of that jealousy, we try to hurt other person. we try to develop the negative feeling for that person and we try to hurt that person or harm that person. That is envy, right? Like out of envy, I drop a snake in front of my neighbor's house.
Ew.
Or I do something which can harm my neighbor. Okay, so that is what is envy. I'm doing all this because of envy. So indirectly, we are envying Krishna because the neighbor's heart also has who?
Krishna.
Krishna. Every living entity's heart has Krishna. So we have to be free from envy. That's what it means by what word? Adroho. And also adroho means resentful. Like we do not go and take revenges from other people or out of envy we hurt other people. Okay, and last part, not the last part, I'm sorry, but yeah, nati manita. So what do you mean by nati manita? Now you see the word na, right?
No.
Yeah, no. So free from the passion for honor, right? Some people like to be honored. We all like to be honored, right? Everybody yeah. should respect me. Everybody should look at me, how nice I look, how nice things I do, right? And we respect honor that everybody kind of should worship me. Not directly taking the aarti plate and worship, but kind of worship me. They should praise me. They should give me respect. They should honor me. So we should be free from that mentality. That's a kind of passion. To receive the honor from others. We should not be expecting honor from others. Okay, but we must give honor to others. You see, what is the difference? We must give honor to others, but we should not be very eager to receive honor from others.
Like all the Maharajas doesn't,
yes.
like they don't want to
Yes,
respect,
Maharajas, all the sannyasis, sadhus, they are free from these qualities.
But
they don't have envy. They are not expecting honor from anybody, but they are being at such a very high level, they still offer all the respect and honor to others because they are at the mode of transcendence. They already have these 26 qualities. So now next comes Bhavanti Sampadam Daivam. Bhavanti means everybody. Bhavanti means, what does Srila Prabhupada says here? Are. Sampadam means the qualities. Daivam means the transcendental nature. Jatasya, of one who is born of Bharata, O son of Bharata. So Srila Prabhupada says all these 26 qualifications mentioned are transcendental qualities. They should be cultivated according to the different statuses of social and occupational order. Purport is that even though material conditions are miserable, if these qualities are developed by practice by all classes of men, then gradually it is possible to rise to the platform of highest transcendental realization. Okay. So here also Srila Prabhupada talks about nati manita. What does it mean? That especially he's talking about the Shudras, that Shudras, they must offer the respect to higher class of people to upkeep the social order. So let's go for our verse quickly. Everybody ready? Yes?
Yes.
Very good. Very good. So let's start, everybody.
Are we doing verse 3?
Verse 3 today. Yes. Tejah Kshama.
Tejah Kshama.
Tejah Kshama.
Tejah Kshama.
Tejah Kshama.
Tejah Kshama.
Tejah Kshama. Dhritihi shaucham.
Dhritihi shaucham. Dhritihi shaucham.
Dhritihi shaucham.
Dhritihi shaucham.
Dhritihi shaucham. Tejahakshamadhritihi shaucham.
Tejahakshamadhritihi shaucham.
Right, later. Pay attention there. Tejahakshamadhritihi shaucham.
शौचम् तेजक्षमा धृतिः शौचम् अद्रोहो नाति मानिता अद्रोहो नाति मानिता अद्रोहो नाति मानिता अद्रोहो नाति मानिता
अद्रोहो नाति मानिता
तेजः क्षमा धृतिः शौचम् अद्रोहो नाति मानिता
अद्रोहो नाति मानिता
अभ्युक्ता वृंदा चित्रायन कृष्णा कार्तिक अन्म्यूट बेटा कम ऑन अन्म्यूट एंड रिपीट आफ्टर मी भवन्ति अम्बदं दैवीं भवन्ति संपदं दैवीं सो एवरीबडी नाउ सी देयर आर टू वेज टू से दिस दैवीं राइट आई कैन से दैवीं बट द राइट वेज टू से दैवीं Do you all see a line on top of I?
I do.
Do you all see a line on top of I in Daivim?
Daivim.
It's a long I. Everybody, it's a long I. Bhavanti sampadam Daivim. Bhavanti sampadam Daivim. भवन्ति संपदं दैवीं भवन्ति संपदं दैवीं
भवन्ति संपदं दैवीं
अभिजातस्य भारत अभिजातस्य भारत
अभिजातस्य भारत
अभिजातस्य भारत अभिजातस्य भारत
अभिजातस्य भारत
वेरी गुड श्यामगौरी रुद्र जानवी सुभद्रा चित्रा आई कैन हियर यू ऑल नाइसली वेरी गुड अभिजातस्य भारत तेजः क्षमा धृतिः शौचम् अद्रोहो नाति मानिता भवन्ति संपदं दैवीं अभिजातस्य भारत वेरी गुड एतेजः क्षमा धृतिः शौचम् अद्रोहो नाति मानिता भवन्ति संपदं दैवीं
भवन्तः संपदा दैवम्
अभिजातस्य भारत
Very good. So we're going to go for repetition. Before that, quickly, everybody has to send the recording of all three verses today. 1, 2, 3. And they have to send me the recording of whole chapter, chapter number 14. So I saw the video of Mathily. I haven't seen Sanvi's yet, but I'm going to see Sanvi. Aditya sent it. Mathily sent it. Sanvi sent it. Krishna's is, I think it has come. Please, everybody else also try. Okay, Garima is going to send it by tomorrow. Yes.
Tomorrow?
Yes. But besides video or not, everybody has to send their recording of chapter number 14 today. Okay. And 16.1, 2, 3. Everybody has to send the three shlokas recordings.
Okay.
In the end, I want to talk to you all a little bit. Okay. So let's continue later. Repetition. 1, 2, 3. Very good. 1, 2, 3. Very good. So I was wondering, who here likes cheesecake?
Me.
Oh my goodness.
Me.
I have both the hands raised. My favorite is cheesecake.
I have three hands raised.
Yes. So I have decided we will soon have a day where we all can have a cheesecake. Now don't ask me who, why, where, and how. Okay. Because that will be a little surprise. But definitely those who are paying attention to this chapter nicely and preparing this chapter nicely. And every day speaking nicely will definitely get the cheesecake. Okay?
I've been writing this.
Okay, yes. Good job. 24
verses are there.
I've already got a cheesecake.
There's 24, not 34.
Don't worry about how many. Don't worry about how many. Okay. So okay. Another thing, in a day or two, okay, did you all enjoy fancy dress competition last chapter?
Yes.
Okay, so we all are going to have again fancy dress competition this chapter.
Yes, not yet.
But definitely you all have to know the meanings of these first three verses, each and every word.
What?
Okay, like I just explained, Shama. Shama means
Shama
what?
Shama means forgiveness.
Yes.
Forgiveness.
What does it mean? Shama means forgiveness. What do you mean by Tejah? Vigor.
Vigor?
Vigor.
Active.
Vigor. Active.
Dritihi. Dritihi means fortitude.
Fortitude.
You'll get it. Chaucham means
cleanliness.
Cleanliness. Very good. Adroho means no envy. Right? No envy. Nati Manita means no honor. Right?
No
passion for receiving honor. Ahimsa
Ahimsa. Everybody, Ahimsa. Ahimsa means
No, I'm not going to get it from downstairs.
No violence, non-violence.
Very good. You can go get it from downstairs. That's exactly what you can. I'm just going to tell them.
Everybody, show me your hands. Satyam. Right? What do we speak from our mouth? Satyam means truthfulness.
Truthful.
Akrodhas.
No, no
akrodhas.
No anger.
Tyagah.
Renunciation.
Shanti.
Calm.
Peaceful. Very good. Apaishunam.
Apaishunam.
Apaishunam. Means
apaishanam means everybody who's going to tell me apaishanam means
apaishanam.
Yes, aversion to fault finding. Aversion to fault finding. I tell you all one thing, if you all do not know the meanings of these 26 words, we cannot have fancy dress competition. So I leave it up to you all. If you all prepare these three verses with meanings properly, each and every word, definitely we can have beautiful fancy dress competition. Yay! But you cannot come on fancy dress. I don't know, Mataji, what does it mean by apaishunam? I have no idea.
Apaishunam,
right?
Means
then how will you show that character?
Aversion
to fault finding. Very good. Wait. Daya. Everybody, daya means
Mercy.
Daya means mercy. Yes. Daya, compassion. Compassion for all living entities, right? Bhuteshwa. Daya Bhuteshwa means compassion to all living entities.
Alolutvam.
Alolutvam.
Freedom from greed. Yes, very good. Freedom from covetousness, right? Covetousness means greed.
Mataji, which verse are we?
Okay, let's do this way. Okay, everybody, Haribol, 1 minute. I know there's a little confusion. Which verse? Let's start from the first verse quickly, okay? Okay, so then that way you will have a sequence also. Okay, is everybody ready?
Yes,
perfect. Okay, abhayam.
Fearlessness.
Very good. Abhay Charan. Yes. Then sattva samshuddhir. Purification of one's existence. Everybody has to speak. I see Chitra. Rudra is trying. Sanvi speaking. Shamagari, I want you to speak. Ayan, speak.
Shubhadra.
Aditya, are you with me, beta? Are you with me on the same sequence?
Yes.
Perfect. Thank you, beta. Varun, are you there, beta, with me? Yes? Okay. Let's go. Sattva samshuddhir means? Purification of one's existence, right? And we discuss
one
about sannyasis. And one of the examples was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how he always maintained the distance with the women. Okay, Jnana Yoga Vyavasthitihi, one word.
Jnana Yoga.
Cultivation of which knowledge?
The knowledge of lifting up.
Cultivation of spiritual knowledge.
Spiritual knowledge.
Very good. Next part. Danam.
Charity.
Danam
means
charity. Charity. Giving.
Charity.
Give me your hands, everybody. Charity. Giving. Charity. Right? Giving. Right? How do you give? Yeah. You give with your hand. One hand, right? Charity.
Mataji, charity is goodness.
Yes, charity is. Yes, but sometimes, you know, people do charity in the mode of ignorance and passion too.
What?
That will come in chapter 18. So what? That is not recommended.
I don't really understand.
Okay, damascha.
No, sir.
Dama means self-control, right? That's okay. Damas means, everybody show me their hands. Self-control. You have to hold on to your senses. You have to control your senses. You have to hold on, right? If you see your friend, you go to school and you go on Ekadashi, and even if you see your friend eating a muffin, even though it is eggless, but it's Ekadashi, what do we do?
Self-control.
I am not going to eat that. We control our tongue.
Self-control.
We control our tongue not to eat that. Self-control. Jama. Then comes yagya. Yagya means what?
Yagya means sacrifice,
right? So how do you sacrifice in Kali Yuga? Everybody, show me your hands.
Krishna.
Chanting. No, everybody show me. No, everybody show me their hands. Beats. Everybody, I just want to see only hand movements. Where is everybody's hand movements? How do you move the beads? Very good. So that is what? Sacrifice. What is that? Sacrifice. Very good. You all are amazing. I'm so proud of you. Next comes, where am I? I forgot. Svadhyaya. Everybody
Study of the Vedas.
Yes. Then comes Tapa. Tapa means austerity.
Austerity,
right? Austerity. Again, of course, same example we can use like we did. Austerity, same Ekadashi fasting rules, regulations, right? Austerity, right? Then comes, what is next? Arjavam. Arjavam means simplicity. Simple life. Arjavam means what? Simple life, simple living, high thinking. Arjavam. Next comes Ahimsa. Ahimsa. Everybody show me the hands.
Ahimsa.
No violence. That means
non-violence.
Very good. Satyam. Everybody show me your hands. Truthfulness. Can everybody see your hands? Truthfulness. What should our mouth speak?
Truth.
And how should we hear the absolute truth? From who?
From the spiritual master.
Very good. Then comes akrodha. I'm going to eat you all up. I'm so angry, right? Akrodha.
No.
Freedom from anger.
No anger. No anger. Very good. Tyagaha. Right? Giving up. But here is renunciation. In the service of Krishna. What do we do? Tyagaha. We utilize everything in the service of the Lord. Right? Okay. Shanti.
Tranquility.
Tranquility means? Peaceful.
Peaceful.
Very good. Apaishunam.
Aversion to fault finding.
Yes, do not go out and keep correcting people unnecessarily, right? And do not take out their faults. Tejaha. Tejaha means vigor, right? Tejaha, fast, active, ready to punish. And it is specially for Kshatriyas. Ready to punish those who are committing sinful activities. Tejaha, everybody show me their hands. Tejaha means vigor. Shama.
Forgiveness.
Shama, yes. Okay, let it go. Forgiveness. Everybody show me their hands.
Mataji.
Wait, I'm coming. Subhadra, wait. So everybody show me their hands. Of course, this hand shows of a blessing, but also at the same time, we forgive you. Right? Forgiveness, Shama. Then comes Dhritihi.
Fortitude.
Fortitude means
Free from?
Fortitude.
Fortitude. I don't know.
No. Fortitude means mental and emotional strength. Even in the conditions of pain and misery. So we should be emotionally strong. Okay. Next comes Shaucham.
Clean.
Shaucham. Clean. What should we show? We should not show our teeth. What should we show? We should show our heart. Right? How do we clean our heart? Every morning. With a brush, right? By chanting. Yes. Shaucham. Adroho. Freedom from envy. Freedom from envy. Very good. Then comes Nati Manita. Nati Manita means freedom from receiving any honor. No honor.
Not expectation of honor.
Yes, not expecting any honor. No honor. Okay. Then comes Bhavanti Sampadam Daivim. Daivim means transcendental nature. And Sampadam means the qualities. And Bhavanti means are. Abhijatasya, of one who is born of. Bharata means O son of Bharata.
O son of Bharata.
Yes, I'm sure. Did everybody get these qualities nicely, properly?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. But you all need to practice. Practice means when you are speaking these verses, you should speak slowly. From today, when you send your recordings, I want you all to send these three recordings very slow. Because when you speak slow, you are thinking Shama. Shama means forgiveness, right? And how are you going to send your these three recordings? I'm going to explain you today. Okay. When you speak verse one, everybody, when you speak verse one, you're going to speak the translation verse one. When you speak verse two, you're going to send your translation verse two. And when you do verse three, you're going to send your translation verse three. Did you all understand?
Yes,
did you all understand?
Yes.
That's how you're going to send your recordings. Otherwise, we cannot have a successful fancy dress competition. It's not possible to have.
Mataji, like do you all. Mataji, if we get stuck and we look at the Bhagavad Gita.
You can look and speak. I'm not telling you to memorize and speak.
Okay.
At the moment, you're going to look and speak at least for a few days.
I have a question.
Not now. So you're going to look and speak, not without looking, because without looking, you might be speaking wrong. We don't want to learn wrong, are we? Instead of forgiveness for Shama, we will say, oh, freedom from envy. So how? It doesn't make sense, right? Okay. Let me explain you a better way. Okay, let's do this way. First, you all go ahead and send your three recordings. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Go ahead and finish it. And after that, Garima, once you finish your sending three verses, after that, you go individual. You have written all like this. Abhayam means. You have written? Just look in your notebook and read it. How do you read? Abhayam means fearlessness. Tattva Samshuddhir means purification of one's own existence. Jnana Yoga Vyavasthitaha means cultivation of spiritual knowledge. Okay, there's a lot of background noise from somewhere. Danam means charity. Damash means self-control.
Yajna
means sacrifice. Svadhyaya means self-study. Tapa means, and then Arjava means. That's how you have to send only these three shlokas. We are not going to do this whole chapter like this, okay? I'm focusing only on these three verses. Do you all get it?
Yeah.
We are not going to whole chapter like this. So don't think. Soumya, one minute. Don't think that we are going to do whole chapter like this. No. See, these are the divine 26 qualities, which is so important to know and work on. If you all don't know these three verses, then the purpose of the chapter does not fulfill. What is the name of the chapter, everybody?
Divine and demoniac nature.
Yes. Now, can you? Yes. Now, can you all look at verse number 4? Verse number 4 talks about which qualities? Pride, arrogance, conceit, anger, harshness, ignorance, cheating others. What are these qualities?
Demoniac.
Demoniac. So,
So demoniac qualities, we will have a different way to do things, right? But the first three verses is divine, right? So that's why we are focusing only on first three verses. Did you all get it? How to send your recordings?
Yes, Master.
Perfect. Yes, when you all do all these wonderful things, definitely you all deserve a cheesecake at least, right? I also deserve one cheesecake, right? Yes or no?
Yes, for teaching
yes,
us.
Energy.
For teaching us.
Thank you so much. No, yes, learning you, so I also deserve a cheesecake. Okay, so here we're going to end the class.
Wait. Mataji?
How do we...
I explain. Yes. So wait, 1 minute. I'm going to end the class here. Everybody can log out unless those who has questions. Okay. Bye. Love you all.
Bye. Bye. Yes, love you.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. I was saying, Mataji.
Bye.
I was saying that. Should we send the three recordings?
Yes, you have to first send the one recording of 1, 2, 3 verse and second recording where you're speaking the meanings of all. Okay? Okay, Bicha?
Like
you say, Abhayam means fearlessness. Then
so Satya
should
say
be,
all...
Samshuddhir mean. Yes, mm-hmm. You have to say all three. Yes.
All the synonyms?
Okay. All three, yes. Uh-huh. It's not a lot, trust me. It's not a lot, okay?
It takes for 5 minutes or two.
Yeah, 5 minutes is not a lot, trust me. You play, you can easily paint for 30 minutes, right? 5 minutes is not a lot. You can do it.
Okay? Mataji, I'll explain. Mataji, and also yes. My dad, one time he had a play date with someone, and someone came over, and my dad made a cheesecake.
Very nice, for
my birthday when I was 1 year old. This is Shubhadra speaking. When I was 1 year old, my mom and dad made a cheesecake for me.
Wow, very it nice. I wish I was there to eat it.
Yes.
My mom made a cheesecake for me when I turned 8. She made so many cheesecakes.
Okay. Now rest tomorrow. We'll talk tomorrow, okay? We'll see you all tomorrow. Bye.
Malavinda,
you have a question? Tell me.
Mataji, I want to say
something. What is it, beta? Tell me.
You were saying in the translation that we should not chant any other thing like not say candy. We should say Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, yes. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Yes.
We should only say Hare Krishna Mahamata. That was a really funny point.
I know. You know, I tell you one thing. When I went to the temple, maybe first or second time, there's a Prabhupada disciple and his name is Balabhadra Prabhu. And one time he was giving lecture. You know what he said? Why don't you all try speaking coke, 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 coke for 100 times and then you see you get tired or not. Of course you get tired. But then when you chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra, you never get tired, right? You can chant for all your life. So that's why I gave the example of candy. By hearing him. Okay. So bye, Bicha. Love you all. See you.